Hello again, this is Kent from SimpleTutorials.net, and this is the Inkscape Tutorials for Beginners series, and we are in the 11th part of the series, in Fill and Stroke. So let me just draw a rectangle. And so how do we change the fill, the green part, and then the stroke, which is the outer edge part? Well, a lot of times the way I do it would be just to click in one of these. If you click in the fill, it'll open up the fill and stroke window. And it will open it up specifically in the fill tab. If you click on stroke, it'll open up in the stroke tab. And of course you can switch back and forth and you go to the stroke style. Almost always use this, the HS, the hexadecimal, I think it's hexadecimal tab, and this, but perhaps you might want to start out using this, because this can be somewhat easier to use, because right now we're in this stroke, but if you go into here and use the wheel, so whatever you're comfortable with would be the easiest, I would say. But if you want to actually copy the hexadecimal number or value to maybe use in like a website or something, this is what you'd be. You want to go to this tab and then copy this value. I can also affect whether it be the stroke or the fill with these sliders. See how it blurs? And do the same thing with opacity, make it more transparent. See, that's transparent now. You can also go down here and change the opacity. Now it's not transparent. But now I put this in front so you can see that this is transparent. Another way to manipulate fill and stroke is by right-clicking over this area, the fill, and you can immediately change this to white. You can do the same with the stroke and you can change this. I'll change it to black. And then you can also change the stroke width by right-clicking over this number. You can make it thicker. It's just a fast way of changing the stroke width. And then over here in the stroke style, there's various styles. When you're using it, the Bezier tool or the pen tool, a lot of times it'll be open, so it kind of looks good to have a rounded end or a rounded cap and the rounded join or joint. And then you can also change the style of the line or the stroke. You can also tie it. Now on your keyboard, hit Control or Shift Control and then W, and it'll bring up a swatch window, which I don't really use that much. But you can change the swatches here. You can hit the Shift key on your keyboard and change the stroke. You know, you see the stroke changing? It'd be easier if I excuse me, make it thicker and then you can see it. Anyway, I'm holding the shift key down and clicking on these colors in the swatch window. You can do the same thing down here, and I'm holding the shift key down still. See, it says shift and that's to change the stroke color. If you don't have it held down, you can just go to any one of these and change the fill. Or you can change the fill over here. And you see this arrow on here on the swatch window. That's what you have to hit to change the colors in here. And then you have a scroll bar. Scroll bar to change the colors within that. And you can also hit Control Shift F to get your fill and stroke window. One thing I forgot to mention, I bring up the hit Control Shift and then fill, or F. Oops, Control Shift F, bring up that, and then select one of these, and we will go into fill to start off. I want to show you the gradient. Now you can do the linear gradient or radial gradient. And let's just do linear gradient. Then you can click on this or hit Control F1. So in your gradient tool, and you can add stops in here by simply double clicking. See, the added another stop, and I added another stop. Now this allows you to put in colors. Now if you want to select one of these, you have to double click it, and you see the gradient editor window pops up. You can go in here and change the color. You see it changed the color right here. And it kind of fades into the other color. I can go over here and select. You have to double click it. And you have to notice this number will change. Now I'll go over here and put in a different color, maybe green. So you see the green in there. Anyway, you can play around with it. That's the easiest way to understand how it works. Is the dropper tool. Perhaps you might have a bitmap or a JPEG, a GIF, or a PNG file that's sitting in here. It's embedded. And you want one of the colors out of that photo or whatever it is. Well, you can go down to your dropper. Now, you can also press F7 to get to your dropper tool. Now, if you want to pick a color, first you want to have something selected. Then you hit your F7, get your dropper tool. And then you can hit any one of these colors. And let's just imagine that this is a photo embedded in your Inkscape file that you're inside. You just click on any one of these colors, even down here. Of course, that's fill. And if you shift to, I guess we're not using that. Now, anyway, a dropper's only really helpful when you're having some other, whether it's a bitmap or another object with the color that you want. That's really when it's helpful the most of the time. You can also, I believe, hit Shift, and you change the stroke of the item that you want to change. Anyway, if you like this video, or please like it, or if you want to subscribe, go ahead and to see other videos that I produce in the future. Thank you.